हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी शैल लर्न सेकेंड क्लास इंग्लिश सेकेंड लेसन. बुक्का लर्न्स अ लेसन. सो द राइटर ऑफ द स्टोरी इज दीपान्विता रॉय. सो हु इज द राइटर ऑफ द स्टोरी? हु रोट द स्टोरी? दीपान्विता रॉय. ओके, सो हु इज बुक्का? बुक्का इन द लेसन, बुक्का इज नेम ऑफ एन एलिफेंट. ही यूज टू बी वेरी नॉटी एंड ही यूज टू irritate everyone with his naughty behavior. Then his elders taught him a lesson. Okay, so what mistakes he made and how he realized from his mistakes, we shall learn in the story. Okay, right? Come on. Remember, you are all big animals. The older elephants warn the juniors. So, older elephants means the big elephants, means mommy elephant, mother elephant, father elephant, this grandfather, grandmother, all these are older, right? So, older elephants warn the juniors. Juniors means the young ones. Growing up, elephants are called juniors, right? Junior elephants. Warn means telling seriously. Telling something very seriously is called warning. Warn, okay? So, what the older elephants are telling to the junior elephants? They are telling them to remember, you are all are big animals. So, the older elephants are warning the junior elephants to remember that they all are big animals. Isn't it? Elephants are very big in size and they are very fat also, right? And they are very heavy also. So, next. When lying down on the ground, you must watch out for snails. So, the older elephants are also telling the juniors to watch out for snails, to check out for snails when they are lying down on the ground. What do you mean by snails? Snails are small animals. They live nearby water bodies like lakes, rivers, ponds, etc. So, snails have a thick shell on their back. They move very slowly. Okay, they live nearby water. Okay, see that you don't crush them under your weight. So, the older elephants are telling the young elephants, that is the junior elephants, to watch out for snails when they are lying down on the ground and also to see they should not crush them under their weight. Crush means pressing something very hard until it breaks down. Okay, pressing something very hard until it breaks down is called crush. So, they should check for snails or else they may crush them under their weight. The older elephants are telling the juniors, right? It is the snail that tells you when flood water enters the forest. So, the older elephants are telling the use of snails, how they are helpful for them. They are telling to the juniors. Snails help them to tell when flood water enters the forest. Flood means when heavy rains falls, then the water from the rivers, lakes overflow and they enter the forest. Okay, the water overflows from the rivers into the forest when heavy rains fall. So, that is called floods. Next, check to see if there are baby squirrels in the hollows of trees. The older elephants are also telling the juniors to check for baby squirrels in the hollows of trees. Hollows means holes or empty spaces in the trees. Okay, when you shake the branches of tree to pick the fruits, generally elephants shake the branches of trees to pick up fruits. When they are shaking, if there are any squirrels in the holes of the trees, they may fall off from the tree, right? And they may get hurt. That's why the older elephants are telling the juniors to check for any squirrels in the holes of trees. Next, these animals will be the first ones to give you news of any danger. So, the older elephants are telling the younger ones how squirrels help them. Squirrels are the first ones to give you news of any danger. So they are telling the squirrels are the first ones to give if any danger is approaching into the forest. The squirrels will bring you news of an approaching forest fire. So if any forest fire approaching means coming nearer. If any forest fire is coming into the forest, then the squirrels are the first ones to give news to everybody of the danger, of the coming danger. Okay, so next, the older elephants do not only teach the young elephants how to live in harmony with others, but also teach them how to live in harmony among their own kind. So the older elephants teach the young elephants to live in harmony with other animals. Okay, harmony means live in peace, to accept with others' thoughts also, to accept or create a situation where everyone agrees with each other. That is called harmony. Simply, it is peaceful situation. Okay, so what the older elephants are telling the younger elephants? The older elephants are telling the young elephants to be in harmony with other animals and also within their herd, within their elephant group also. Okay, next. When you get news of good food, the elders tell the juniors, you must not eat alone. So what the elder elephants are also telling the juniors? They are also telling the juniors that when they get any news of good food, then they should not eat alone. They must send a message to others. You must send a message to others. So the elders are telling the juniors to send a message to other animals if they find any good food, because sharing is caring. Okay, if you share food, that gives happiness also. So that is what the elder elephants are telling to the junior elephants. And if any member of the herd faces danger, everyone must rush to help. So the older elephants are also telling the junior elephants that if any member of the herd means elephant group is called herd, group of elephants is called herd. If any elephant, if any member of the herd faces any danger, everyone must rush to help. Rush means come running. They must come running to help the elephant. You should always remember, however big you are, you might face danger if you are alone. The elders are telling the young ones that if you are alone, however so big you are also, you might face danger. So the elder elephants are telling the juniors that however so big you are also, if you are alone, you might face danger. So you need help of others. Even though they are small or big, everyone is helpful to us. We need everyone. So we need help of others, however so much big we are. That is the good things that elder elephants are telling to the junior elephants. Okay. The young elephants listen to their elders with rapt attention. So what do you mean by rapt attention? Means full attention, complete attention, with full interest. All other young elephants are listening to the elders. Okay, all other young elephants listen to their elders with complete attention, rapt attention. Okay, next. But there is one elephant, that is Bukka. Only Bukka does not like to listen to all this. Only Bukka does not like to listen to all this. Bukka knows that one day he will become the leader of the herd. What Bukka is thinking? Bukka is thinking that one day he will become leader of the herd. Herd means elephant group, as I already told you. Okay, he's thinking that he will become leader of the elephant group. He will become huge. He will become huge and have those big tusks. So he's thinking if he becomes lead I mean huge. If he becomes big, he might get big tusks. So tusks means, what do you mean by tusks? The white pointed teeth what elephant has, they are called tusks. So it is feeling that it will one day become very huge and it will have that big big tusks, and he will become the leader of the herd one day. He is thinking like that. Okay, so everyone in the jungle will be afraid of him. He is thinking that if he grow up and if he gets that big tusks, then everyone will be afraid of him and he will become the leader of the herd. He is thinking like that. Okay, so Bukka doesn't bother to make friends with those small creatures at all. So Bukka doesn't bother. Bother means care, does not care. Bukka does not want to care about the other small animals. He does not want to make friends with other small animals. Small creatures means small animals like squirrels, snails, etc. Okay, so he doesn't want to make friends with the other small animals. He feels they are of no need to him. They are of no help for him. He is so big and so huge that he doesn't want to make friendship with those small creatures. Okay, next. Am I a fool that I will share any good food that I find? He is thinking to himself. What he is thinking to himself? Am I a fool to share my good food with others? Thinks Bukka. In fact, I should be eating all that good food, shouldn't I? He is thinking to himself. If I get any good food, why will I share to others? I myself eat the good food. He is thinking to himself. I have to grow up quickly. Only then I will grow up quickly. Since I have to grow up quickly, I should not share food with others. I will eat all the food good food which I get. He is thinking like that. Okay. After all, I have to become the leader one day. He is thinking that he has to become huge. He has to grow up very fast and he want to become leader of the group one day. So Bukka breaks off flowers and also branches with nests. So what he is doing? He is doing all the naughty things like breaking off flowers. He is breaking the flowers. He is pulling the flowers. Okay, and also branches with nests. Branches have generally nests, right? Birds form nests on the branches. Bukka did not care about the birds in the nest. It used to shake the branches of the trees. It used to pull off the flowers from the plants. It used to break the flowers from the plants. And in this way, he crushes snails underfoot. So under his foot, he crushes snails. So in this way, he used to do all the naughty things, naughty behavior. He used to be very naughty. Okay, next. He squirts water into rabbit holes with his trunk. So long trunk. With his long trunk, he brings water from the pond and he squirts water into rabbit holes. Squirts means sprays. He sprays water into rabbit holes. All the animals are tired of his mischief. Mischief means naughty behavior. So what happened? All the animals are very much tired of his naughty behavior, of his mischief. One day they complained to the leader of the elephant herd. So all the other animals came to the leader of the elephant herd and they complained about the Bukka's naughty behavior. Please do something, they tell the leader. All the other animals came to the leader of the elephant herd and they told him to do something. Please do something, they told. Okay, Bukka is becoming very naughty. The leader hears them out and realizes that naughty Bukka needs to be taught a lesson. So the leader of the elephant group, that is the leader of the herd, hears all the complaints from all the animals and he realizes that he should teach Bukka a lesson. He thought he needs to teach some lesson to Bukka. That night, like always, Bukka goes to sleep next to his mother's warm side. So like every day, that night also Bukka was sleeping next to his mother's warm side. Warm side means next to his mother's stomach, next to his mother's belly, so that it keeps him warm. Okay, but in the morning he wakes up surprised. Means in the morning he got up and he was surprised. Why? Let us see why he was surprised. Surprised means wondered. Something happened which he never expected. That is called surprise. Something happening which never expects is called, then we feel surprised. Okay. But in the morning he wakes up surprised. He was wondered. He finds himself alone on the banks of small pool. He never expected this. He was left alone. He finds himself alone on the banks of small pool. Small pool in the sense small pond, small lake. Okay. Banks means on the sides of small pool, on the sides of this small pond. Okay. So next day he found himself alone on the banks of the small pool. There is simply no one. There was no one around him. Bukka jumps up and searches near the pool. Near the pool, that is near the pond, he jumped here and there. He searched near the pool, but no, there is no sign of elephant herd. But he did not find any elephant herd nearby the pool. Okay, he lifts his trunk to catch the smells floating in the breeze. So he lifted his trunk and he was trying to catch the smells floating in the breeze. Breeze means a slow moving air is called breeze. If air moves very slowly, that is called breeze. In that breeze, sometimes we smell good smells, right? In the same way, he was trying to catch the smells of an elephant herd. Okay, so no luck there. Bukka feels frightened. So even then he could not smell the elephant. He could not smell the elephant herd floating in the breeze. So there was no luck there also. Bukka feels frightened means he was afraid. He was so much afraid. Frightened means afraid. He starts crying. Then he started crying. What will happen now? He was thinking, what will happen now? I am left alone. I can find no one around me. He was thinking like that. Where will he find his parents in such a huge and dense forest? Dense means thick. Okay, very thick forest. He was thinking, where can I find my parents in such a huge and dense forest? In a big, huge means very big and thick forest. Where will I find my parents? He was thinking. Okay, poor Bukka turns to the birds. Means poor Bukka turns to the birds. Turns means he went for help to the birds. Okay, animals and insects in the forest. He went to ask for help. Poor Bukka turns to the birds, animals and insects in the forest for help. Okay, he went and asked all the birds, animals and insects in the forest for help. But they all turn away. But they all turn away means they were not interested to help Bukka. They turn away. They were not interested. They did not accept to help Bukka. The squirrel says, have you forgotten how you shook the branches and made us fall? The squirrel was telling to Bukka, have you forgotten how you shook the branches and made us fall? Shook means moving forward and backward very fast. Moving something forward and backward very fast is called shook. Means shaking, to shake. Okay. So the squirrel says to Bukka, what it was saying? It was saying that, have you forgotten that you shook the branches and made us to fall? So we don't want to help you. Squirrels said like that. Again, Bukka went to rabbit for help. Okay, the rabbit mother says, don't you remember how you poured water down our hole? So rabbit's mother was also saying to Bukka, have you forgotten? Don't you remember that you poured water down our hole, burrows? In our burrows, we were nearly died. We nearly died. Now see how it feels. So we were like nearly we died because of that water you poured in our burrows. So we are not interested to help you. We don't want to help you. Rabbit also told to Bukka. Now see how it feels. Now can you feel the pain? Now are you feeling the pain? He's asking, rabbit mother is saying to Bukka like this. See how it feels. Serves you right. You deserve this punishment. Serves you right means you deserve this punishment. So next, Bukka went to butterflies for help. The butterflies too refused to help him. Refuse means telling no. Refusing means telling no. The butterflies also told no to help him. They too refused to help him. Okay. So next, Bukka starts crying. Then what happened? Bukka started crying. Bukka starts crying. And then he falls asleep crying beside the pool. He was crying and he felt asleep beside the pool. Okay, next day when he wakes up, he finds himself sleeping right in the middle of his herd. Next day he woke up and he saw everyone around him. He was in the middle of his elephant herd. Okay, next to his mother's warm belly. Belly means stomach. He found himself sleeping next to his mother's warm belly. Then next day, he woke up and he saw all the elephants, and he found himself sleeping right in the middle of his elephant herd next to his mother's warm belly, warm stomach. Okay, next, was that a dream? He was thinking, what was happened the before day? Was that a dream? He was thinking. Thinks Bukka to himself. He was thinking to himself, what was happened the before day? Is it a dream? Was it a dream? He was thinking. After that day, no one complains about Bukka ever again. From that day onwards, nobody complained about Bukka ever again. Okay? So, he realized his mistake. What happened? He realized his mistake. He used to think if he is so big and so huge that everyone will be afraid of him, he doesn't want help of anybody. He used to feel like that. But that day, that night, whatever happened was a lesson to him. Okay, he realized his mistake. He came to know that everyone is important. So we should not harm others.